you holding steady at him, Tony.
Good. Keep your eyes peeled, Kelly. We're going to have our hands full when they start working topsides.
My eyes are already peeled, Pappy.
Now I'm going to be Mrs. Paul Jordan. Oh, I'll make you happy, Paul, I swear it. I'll even stop drinking, I promise. I'll be a good wife. The kind of wife you've always wanted. The kind of wife that... Paul? Paul, are you listening to me?
Yeah, I'm listening all right. Every tear-stained word, every lying, deceitful, double-crossing word. Look, lover, I've got a wedding gift for you. It's the only gift you'll ever get from me.
Adventures in Paradise, brought to you by... Mitchner's Adventures in Paradise. Starring Gardner McKay as Adam Troy. With James Holden as Clay Baker, Sink or Swim. Guest stars, Constance Towers, John Daner.
Recently, one of the world's best-known manufacturers of swimming suits sent four beautiful models, a fashion photographer, and a public relations man to Tahiti to photograph its latest creations against the authentic backgrounds of the South Seas. This story, while fictional, is nonetheless based on an actual expedition to the land of paradise.
Monsieur Jordan?
Yes.
Inspector Bouchard, Tahiti Police. We have a box for you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, it arrived just this morning, heavily insured. If you will come with me, please.
Good, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. How do you pronounce your first name, Mademoiselle Gilbert?
That's why everyone calls me Gilbert.
You were born in New York City.
On a subway. The fare was only a nickel.
Merci, mademoiselle.
Thank
merci.
You. Marianne Hughes, born in Atlanta. That's in Georgia. And I'm sure, don't bother reading the date.
Merci, mademoiselle. Miss Laura Knight, Chicago, Illinois, USA. Enchantée, mademoiselle. Merci. Daniel Durand, from Paris. Lovely city, n'est-ce pas?
Oh, oui, monsieur.
Enchanté, mademoiselle. Merci, mademoiselle.
Merci, monsieur.
And you say they are worth more than 50,000 American dollars?
The wrong people, yes.
Formidable.
Now in Paris, you have the same problem, Inspector. You're familiar with the fashion industry there, aren't you?
But of course. I have been head, how do you say that, headquartered in Paris many years, you know. Monsieur Jordan, tell me something. These charming ladies you have brought along with you, they are models?
Direct from New York. When my company goes, Inspector, we go first class.
Of course you do. You know, in France, we have a famous saying, ces femmes sont le tonnerre. You know, translated, it means those girls are made of thunder.
Ah, well, the only trouble with thunder, Inspector, is that it's usually accompanied by lightning and rain. See? Thank you very much for your help. Right. Very kind of you.
It's tough to be.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Well, ladies, it's 4:45. You can take the rest of the afternoon off, see the sights, and enjoy yourselves. I've got errands to do.
Aye, aye, Admiral.
Now, we're sailing first thing tomorrow morning, so no late hours. You understand? Boy, we see that this luggage gets to the Papeete Hotel.
one thing they can say about you, Mr. Jordan. You sure know how to spend a franc or two.
Now, Gilbert.
Yes?
Keep your eye on Danielle, will you?
I know. She's new to the business. Well, come along, ma chérie. You'll find me very kind to stray kittens, men, and wood nymphs. Not necessarily in that order.
You just stick with Gilbert, honey. She knows her way around.
Thanks, heaps.
Any instructions for me, Coach?
Just one. Stay sober.
Paul, that was a low blow.
I mean it, Laura. This trip is strictly business.
But then take me with you, and we'll both stay out of trouble.
No, you run along with the girls. I've got to stop by the hotel and then see a man about a boat.
Right, Paul. But be careful. Remember, I've got a lot of years invested in you.
Just practicing.
You'll have to pardon me. I should have knocked. Have you thought of taking up needlework?
No. Oh, I'm going to a party tonight.
Uh-huh.
A real authentic Tahitian-type party.
As what, Sweet Leilani?
Is that?
Coming, sure.
Who's here?
That's Amy.
Amy?
Amy, that's French for friend. She's taking me to the party.
Are you coming, monsieur?
Quick as a bunny, honey. So long, Pappy. Don't wait up.
You have any openings left in your dance card? Let me know.
Well, now, that's what I call relaxed. Captain Troy, I'm Paul Jordan.
How do you do, Mr. Jordan? We've been expecting you. Welcome aboard.
Well, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be aboard. My, this is a long, long way from Madison Avenue, isn't it? But it's exactly what I had in mind.
Good. Sit down.
Thank you.
Well, your letter said you wanted to go to Mangatora with four passengers.
Yes, there's myself and four women. They're all working for my company.
The letterhead said, sea queen fashions.
Swimwear, high-fashion female bathing suits. $29.95 a copy. Grab one while they're hot.
Oh, you mean the whole expedition's about bathing suits?
We're photographing next year's line. We call it South Seas a la mode. Delicious, but demure. Delightful, but devastating. You like that pitch? I wrote it.
Byron couldn't have written it better.
Byron didn't make my kind of money. The way it's going to work is this, Captain. I've got a photographer and a ton of equipment. Once we get set up on Mangatora, we'll take a few thousand pictures in color, black and white, and then back to New York under lock and key.
Now, don't tell me someone would want to steal your bathing suit pictures.
As a matter of fact, Captain, that's part of your job, to see that they aren't stolen. Our chief competitor is Ed Anderson, that Sun Goddess, and he'll pay $50,000 to anyone who can deliver photos of our new line 3 months before we go into production. It's like Paris or Detroit, a friendly little game of competition.
Well, I don't have much experience guarding bathing suits, but I'll try.
All I ask is that you keep your eyes open. And in the case of the four young ladies who will be your passengers, that should present no problem.
Sounds reasonable. When do you want to sail?
Tomorrow morning early.
Good. Have your people on board by 7 o'clock.
Fine. Oh, and one more thing, Captain. Those suits represent a $1 million sales campaign. You might remind your crew about that.
You worry about your models, Mr. Jordan. I'll worry about my crew.
Fair enough. Thank you very much. Good night.
Lover boy.
girl, lover boy. It's such a warm night. Wouldn't it be nice to go for a swim? That's if I could swim.
What are you doing in that?
Oh, just having a fitting. All models have fittings. It's fitting to have a fitting, isn't it?
You're drunk.
Let's just say I'm working on it. I met some nice friends in Papayete. Taxi cab driver told me he brought you here. Paul. Paul, have you ever drank? Drunk? Drank a Tahitian tiger? I did. 3 of them.
All right, we'll go back to the hotel now. Come on.
Paul, I've been thinking about that $50,000. It's very admirable, really. I always wanted to marry a man who thinks big. That's my motto. Never steal anything small.
All right. Come on. Let's go. Come on, stand up straight.
How's your head?
Is it really morning?
How's that?
Pappy, would you mind speaking in a whisper?
We ready for sea, Adam Tony?
That's good, Kelly. Listen, I guess you're gonna have a lot of equipment, so get some of your friends to help us load.
All right, Captain.
It could happen to you, brother.
Not me, brother. I drink coconut milk.
This is an important charter, Clay. You have a good fee, so from now on, business, you know, strictly sea business.
Oh, Pappy, you know I don't fool around once I put my mind to it.
Passengers here, Adam Tanner.
That's us. Come on, forget the deck.
Heli my alco. Manu, too far. Bring baggage. Put on boat. There's our charter.
Hello, the ship.
Girls!
Hello, Jordan.
Good morning, Skipper. Captain Troy, may I present Miss Knight?
How do you do?
How do you do?
Miss Hughes?
Oh, hi there.
Hi.
Mademoiselle Durand.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
And Gilbert.
Welcome aboard the Tiki, Gilbert.
Good to be aboard, Troy.
Mr. Baker, show our passengers below. Ladies, this is my mate, Clay Baker.
How do you do?
Howdy. It's my pleasure, ladies. Now, if y'all will just follow me.
This way, ladies. Right back through there.
Hi, this is lovely. Very nice.
Oh. Hmm. Not bad. Not bad at all.
Y'all are kind of cute, Mr. Knight.
Would you mind repeating that, ma'am?
I said y'all are kind of cute, Mr. Knight.
Are you from the South, honey?
Sure not.
What part?
All of me.
Thank you.
Come in.
Paul, we're ready for work.
Yeah, I'll be right up.
Paul, I'm sorry about last night. I mean, really sorry.
Forget it. I've had a few drinks in my time.
I remember.
Well, we have a long day ahead of us. No, no, no. You'll only have to redo your makeup. Come in.
Gilbert said to tell you we are waiting, Monsieur Jordan.
You look like a million francs, honey. I'll be right out.
Okay.
Good.
Smile, sweet words for her. Laura gets the sad songs.
Take it easy, will you?
Danielle, honey, Danielle, darling. Dear little Danielle, your little protege, your great discovery. I'm sick of hearing it.
I said shut up.
Oh, I'm fed up, Paul, up to here. Look, you've got a commitment with me, lover boy, whether you like it or not. I'm part of your dirty little double cross, and I'm part of your dirty little life. No, you'd better learn to live with it.
Wind holding steady, Adam Tunney.
Good. Keep your eyes peeled, Kelly. We're going to have our hands full when they start working topsides.
My eyes are already peeled, Pappy.
Say, Captain, we have a lot of equipment. I wonder if some of your men would like to help. I'd be glad to
say no more, Mr. Jordan. Tennessee is known as the volunteer state.
You know, Kelly, that might be the first time Clay ever volunteered for anything.
Stomach in. In. Pull it up. That's it. That's in. This is the Army, ladies.
Stick your head up. Big eyes. Press your lips. Round mouth.
Little more. That's it.
That's it. Got it. Hold it.
Good.
All right, come on,
okay,
let's go.
Okay, mister, everything. Let's go.
Yes, sir. I mean, ma'am.
Oh, Gilbert, come on. Let's try some new angles.
Watch your lips. Get that arch. Okay.
Hold it. Got it.
Still. Now, open your mouth. Give me that
salty
look.
Well, not like a fish, babe. Just a little bit. That's it. Now, big eyes. Okay, got it. Put your foot up, Nine. No, the other one. Clay up with that reflector. All right, honey, now tilt your head back. Yeah, that's it. Go back. Head up. Glasses up. That's fine.
Look, honey, this is the South Seas. Act like you're enjoying it.
Got it. Now, tilt your head up just a little more.
Over a little more, honey. Over. Over. That's it. Good. Nice. Put the umbrella. Now put the arm up. Eyes. No, on top of your head. Yeah, that's it. That's good. Hold it.
Baby, tilt your head up more. Yeah, towards me. No, towards me. Now up a little. And kind of, you know, open your mouth. Watch your lips. Get that look like you're ready to meet your boyfriend. Ecstasy, honey. All right, now do something with the skirt. Drape it over this leg. Come on, gracefully.
Beautiful. Hold it, Joy.
Well, if I'd known, I would have worn my bikini or something.
You don't have to, honey. You make a good study, Troy. I could
photograph you anytime, any place.
Have a good day's work?
Not bad. We'll do better when we get to the island. The Admiral hang us from the yardarm if we don't.
The Admiral?
Jordan, the Madison Avenue martinet.
He acts like a man in a hurry with no place to go.
Oh, he's been. That's what's eating him. He came and went, and when you're a man like Paul Jordan and you get passed by, you're in trouble. He was going to set New York on fire, but he forgot his matches.
What's with that one?
You like?
What's not to like?
Miss France, front and center. In case you two haven't been formally introduced, Captain Troy, Mr. Rand, Danielle for short.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Well, that takes care of today's mad badge.
Well, I guess we reach Mangatora tomorrow morning.
So your mate told me.
Clay? He really gets around, doesn't he?
You mean he likes girls?
Like a fish likes water.
You think that bad, Captain?
Well, I guess it's not so bad.
Stinks. 10 years of it and it stinks. Not now, Laura, later. Not now, lover, later. Later, later, later. I could quote that line in my sleep.
All right, you've made your point.
Made my point? I haven't even rolled the dice yet.
That's enough.
There's a captain up there on deck, lover boy. A legal, lawful ship's captain. And we're on the high seas in case you haven't looked out a porthole. Do you know what that means?
No, you tell me.
It means that Captain Adam Troy, or whatever his name is, has the legal, lawful right to marry us. How do you get the point, Mr. Jordan?
You're drunk.
I'm sober. I've never been so sober. You've got it all worked out, haven't you, Paul? You pocket the money and everybody else takes the blame. Or they'll say that Gilbert was careless with the negatives, or one of the men down at the lab made himself some extra stills, or a dozen other people slipped up. But not Paul Jordan, loyal company man. Now he comes off smelling like a rose.
I said I've had about enough.
And I've had just about enough too, Paul. Now it's this way. Marry me before this cruise is over, or I'll tell everybody within the sound of my voice that Paul Jordan's a cheap crook and that he's selling out his own company for $50,000. I'll yell so loud that they'll hear me in Lindy's.
That's the way it is, huh?
That's the way it is.
But let me tell you the way it is with me. I'm not about to marry you. Not tonight, not tomorrow, not a year from Tuesday. And if you so much as open your mouth, say anything to anybody, I'll kill you, Laura. That's the way it is.
Secure the spring lines fore and aft.
Power and secure, Skipper.
It was nice going, Captain. Now, how long will it take us to get inland?
About as long as it takes you to walk from Lexington to Park Avenue. Mangatora is not a very big island.
Good. All right, ladies. In your uniforms. We start shooting in 30 minutes. Come on the double.
He was with Nelson in Trafalgar.
Danielle.
Yes?
There's some beautiful spots on this rock pile. I'd like to show them to you later.
Oh, thank you, Captain Troy. I would like to see them, if Monsieur Jordan approves.
How much farther, Captain?
Just up ahead.
I'm beginning to feel just like Tarzan.
Oh, just so you don't start looking like him, honey.
There's your spot.
That's quite a location.
Pool has no bottom and the water's pretty treacherous, so I tell your people to take it easy.
Just like a movie set. Well, come on, girls, let's get to work.
Jordan.
Let Gilbert handle it. We came a long way to get these pictures.
Jordan, I think you'd better...
Just mind your own business, Captain, please.
Gilbert, I can't. I'm afraid.
She'll be all right when she wakes up. No thanks to you.
She's being paid for her work, Captain. And paid well.
It's all my fault, Captain. I'm terribly sorry. I didn't realize.
Oh, now, Gilbert, you were only doing your job. You don't owe apologies to anybody.
But I've wanted to apologize. Captain, if there's anything I can do...
I think the best thing we can do is to let her get some rest.
All right.
May I say something, please?
Yes?
You are misjudging Monsieur Jordan, Captain Troy. Paul Jordan is a good man. Believe me, I know.
We're all set, Skipper.
Set for what?
Picture taking's all finished. Marianne and me have organized a luau.
Have fun.
Oh, come on, Skipper. Everybody's gonna be there, and Kelly's gonna provide the music.
And I'm Tony. I brought my drums.
Look, even Laura and Mr. Jordan have made up. Besides, I cooked the dinner myself.
All right. I'll come and spite it.
Come on!
Cheer up, Captain Bly. Nobody's gonna mutiny tonight.
Well, might as well take some shots. I can use them for a publicity tie-up.
The natives are restless tonight. I gotta get that.
Captain, I did not mean to be angry with you this afternoon. I would like, how do you say, make an apology?
Well, however you say it, it sounds fine.
After dinner, would you show me the places on the island you talked about?
With pleasure.
All right, now, kids, freeze!
Attention! Attention, comrades.
Attention. Well, gather round. An important announcement's about to be made. I am pleased and privileged to make the announcement of the forthcoming marriage of the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Thomas S. Knight of Chicago, Miss Laura Knight, to Mr. Paul Jordan of New York City.
Hey, bravo! Hey, bravo! Bravo! Great. Bravo!
You're all invited to attend this joyous event.
Like that.
Oh, Monsieur Jordan, I'm so happy for you.
Congratulations, Mr. Jordan. You got yourself a fine girl.
Mena okua, aloha ko. That means good luck in native talk.
Good luck, honey bun. Nothing beats mare in the bar. Thank you.
Congratulations, Laura.
Thank you, Captain.
Congratulations, Laura. I'm just very happy for you.
Congratulations, Jordan.
Thank you.
Captain,
you have the authority to perform a wedding ceremony, haven't you?
On board the Tiki, I do.
Well, we'll be aboard the Tiki tomorrow. How does a noon wedding sound to you, dear?
I wouldn't care if it were before breakfast.
Then noon tomorrow, you turn into a justice of the peace. Now, Gilbert,
yes,
come here.
Yes, sir.
I am booking you as number one witness.
Well, I've been booked for worse.
Mr. Jordan, can I be a witness?
Oh, now? Honey, if anybody should be a witness, it's you. Well, now, you want to go for a walk with your old man? It's the last chance you get to kiss me while I'm still single. Come on, excuse us, please. Thank you.
Isn't it wonderful, Captain Troy? Isn't love wonderful?
Love? Love certainly is wonderful.
See such a night?
Not even in Georgia.
I used to think the nights was pretty good back in Jonesboro, but they was nothing like this.
Maybe it's the company, Mr. Maid.
Maybe that's just what it is.
Would you like a souvenir photo of Magnetora?
Then he brought me to America. He paid my fare and he gave me my first job as a model.
Jordan did all that for you, huh?
Oh, more, much more. Would you like to hear the rest? Are you really interested?
Oh, yeah, I'm fascinated.
Monsieur Jordan was in love with my mother. It was during the war. He was an American soldier in France. When the Americans entered Paris, Monsieur Jordan met my mother. They fell in love, very much in love.
This was before you were born.
Oui.
But they never married.
Oh, he promised to send for my mother when he went back to America after the war was over. But he never did. Very soon, my mother married a French soldier. We were very poor. After 10 years, he died.
And Jordan never came back to Paris.
I don't know. But for 20 years, every month, my mother received a check from Monsieur Jordan. Sometimes it was a large one, sometimes a very small one. But every night, when we sat down at the table for dinner, my mother and I, we offered a prayer to Monsieur Jordan.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I misjudged him. Daniel.
Yes, Captain?
Adam.
Adam.
You don't what?
Please, I would like to be alone for a little while.
Congratulations, lover.
Paul, are you very angry?
Well, it had to happen sooner or later, I suppose.
Do you mean it?
Why not?
I thought maybe after all these years that, you really did love me. I thought maybe this way wouldn't be so terrible.
You did a lot of thinking, didn't you, lover?
Paul, I'm the happiest girl in the world. It's a pretty corny line, isn't it? That's how I feel. I mean, really feel. It's been so long, and somehow I didn't think it would ever really happen, and now it...
Now what?
Now I'm going to be Mrs. Paul Jordan. Oh, I'll make you happy, Paul, I swear it. I'll even stop drinking, I promise. I'll be a good wife. The kind of wife you've always wanted. The kind of wife that... Paul? Paul, are you listening to me?
Yeah, I'm listening all right. Every tear-stained word, every lying, deceitful, double-crossing word. Look, lover, I've got a wedding gift for you. It's the only gift you'll ever get from me. Now, you get this straight because I'm not going to say it again. Tomorrow morning, when the others ask about this little wedding ceremony you cooked up, you're going to tell them you're not feeling well and that we've decided to wait till we get back to New York. Have you got that straight?
Yes.
Have you got it straight?
Yes, every word of it.
Now, we'll have no more of this ever again.
Tell them every word of it just the way you want me to.
You know I mean this, Laura.
Yes. I'm sure you do.
Come on, come on. Now listen, there's one more thing.
What's that?
My deal with Anderson.
Anderson?
Selling the photographs to our competitors. Half of the $50,000 is still yours.
I don't want it, any of it.
If we cook this deal up together, you're in for half.
This was your scheme, Paul, all of it. I don't want any of your money.
Listen, I made a bargain and I intend to stick with it. When I sell those photographs, half of that money is yours.
Oh, you're very generous, aren't you? Over tipping porters, bringing that little French girl over from Paris, spending like a millionaire. Isn't that the way you pay off your own guilt?
All right, you think I'm overpaying you? Make it $10,000. That's your share. I don't care what you do with it.
You can't even steal by yourself, can you? Somebody else has got to share in your misery. Well, it's not going to be me, Paul. Find yourself another partner.
What's wrong with you, Laura? You're talking crazy. You're going to talk, aren't you? That's what's on your mind, isn't it?
Don't you remember what you said to me, Paul? People make a living stealing designs in Detroit, Rome, Paris. It's all part of the game, you said.
Listen, if word about this gets around, I'll be finished for good. I'll wind up in prison. Is that what you want? Is that what you're after? Are you trying
let
to ruin me?
No,
are you?
Me.
You're not going to. I won't let you. No, no. Now you get up before I hit you again. Get up. An accident. She must have fallen in the pool. But it was too late to do anything for her. Danielle, there's nothing either of us can do. Now, you've got to trust me, Danielle. Danielle, I've never hurt you, have I? I've never lied to you. I've always been good to you. I've had your best interests at heart all my life, haven't I?
Oui, monsieur.
All right. Then all I ask is that you believe me now.
believe you.
Thank you, Danielle. You don't owe me anything more than that.
You did your best, Skipper.
You were with Laura when you left the party. What happened?
Well, she said she wanted to take a walk alone. We agreed to meet later on.
That simple?
No, no. I met Danielle afterwards on the path, and we heard Laura's cry and the splash, and then when we got here, there was no sign of her at all. Look, I've told you all of this before. Why don't you say whatever is on your mind and be done with it?
All right, I will. Since when does a happy groom-to-be let his fiancée go walking alone in the jungle at night?
You told us this island was deserted. Now, how was I to know that she'd get herself in trouble?
You all had better get back to the ship. Show them the way, Kelly. Oh, Clay?
Yes, Captain.
You stick with me. We're not finished.
Now, take it easy, honey. Nobody's gonna hurt you if you'll just take it nice and easy. I'm gonna take my hand away. Now, but if you scream, I'm gonna have to get rough, and I don't wanna do that, okay? The skipper wants to talk to you right away.
Adam?
Yeah. Come on with me now.
What does he want with me? I didn't do anything.
And when the skipper says bring you, I bring you. That's the way it is. Now, come on.
Monsieur, I haven't done anything.
Maybe you have, maybe you haven't.
Does he think I killed Laura?
Who said anything about killing? She drowned, didn't she?
Oh, yes, of course she drowned. It was an accident. No one could have saved her.
Suppose I tell you something. Adam and me found Laura's body. Adam didn't want to bring it up till you folks had all left. You know something else? Laura's face and arms were all covered with bruises. You don't get that way from falling into the water.
Then you think...
Well, we don't think anything. Except Skipper wants to see you, and he said right now.
Danielle! Danielle! I want to talk to you! To me, Danielle, please. I wouldn't hurt you, Danielle. I'd never hurt you, but you must listen to me. Danielle, please. Now, you wouldn't tell them. Now, Danielle, you couldn't tell them. Please, Danielle. Danielle, I'm your father. Danielle! Danielle!
Clay! Clay! Danielle! Danielle!
Danielle! Danielle, listen to me. Please, Danielle. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm not gonna hurt you, Danielle. But you have to stop running.
No, you killed Laura.
It was an accident, Danielle. It was an accident. I didn't mean to kill her.
Now, you gotta believe me.
Danielle, your mother and I, we loved each other very much. But I had a good job waiting in the States. A chance to make a lot of money. I couldn't get married then, Danielle. I couldn't. I was just a kid then. Danielle, will you listen to me, please? Please, Danielle.
No, I will never listen to you. You are lying to me. You are not the person I thought you were.
Danielle, you can't tell them. You can't tell them you'll ruin everything. Danielle, will you listen to me? I have money, darling. I have money. Lots of money. I have $50,000, and it's all of it's yours.
Danielle! Jordan is locked up, Inspector. I believe you have something that belongs to me.
Your gun, Captain Troy? From your own cabin, Nesper?
Yes. Usually keep it under lock and key, but Jordan broke the lock.
Well, that will be all. I hope your stay in Papeete will be a bit more pleasant in the future. Bonjour.
Well, I'd feel a lot safer with the police escort.
Mademoiselle, I know just such an escort.
Oh, you do?
Oui. Be in Quinn's bar at 5 o'clock, huh?
My pleasure, Monsieur Inspector.
I can think of a lot cozier places than a bar, then. You stick with me and we'll turn this island inside out.
Mr. Mate? I'm ready to go native.
Captain Troy, still one mystery remains. What about this body you said you found in the lagoon? Miss Laura Knight's body was not recovered. That pool is bottomless.
Well, Jordan's story didn't make any sense. When we got to him, he was with Danielle. So I figured she knew something she was too frightened to tell us.
So you invented the body to frighten her even more? Not very gentlemanly of you, Captain Troy, but quite effective. It is remarkable what these amateurs can sometimes do, Inspector.
Inspector, Captain Troy is no amateur.
Au revoir. Au revoir, mon cher.
Thank you.
Adventures in Paris.